Hey, artist. Today we're going to be taking a look at some painting techniques. We're going to just make some paper because we're doing a unit on Jean-Michel Basquiat, who is an amazing artist. And first thing we need to do for today is we're going to be making colorful painted pieces of paper so that we can later collage and draw over these papers. But first, today we're just going to work on painting papers. So we're going to make two. So I've already created one, so I'm going to just kind of show you how I go about this process. Now, what you will notice is my palette of paint. I just have a few colors, and I'm using a big, thick brush, and I'm not even going to wash or rinse the brush in between the different colors that I'm going to be putting on. So I think I'm going to start, because last time I started with the darker colors. So this time I'm going to start, and I'm just going to put down a little bit of orange paint, and I'm going horizontally and vertically, and I don't want a whole lot. I'm going to switch into red shortly after and just kind of trying to paint the whole paper and get as much of that white space to disappear as I possibly can. So my orange is just going to be a little bit in the middle there. And then I'm going to really spread that red around. And then, without even rinsing my brush, I am going to change to blue. So, because my brush will still have a little bit of orange and red in it, it'll probably create some cool blends and color combinations. And then I'm just going to keep painting, and it's starting to look a little purple where the red and the blue are mixing together. And then, as I get that blue to take up more space on my paintbrush, the red is going to fall away and just give in to the blue so that we have mostly blue. A little bit of purple in there. Now I'm going to go ahead and finish with green. So this one's going to have a lot of green. I did not rinse my brush in between. I'm going to kind of go horizontally and vertically, and don't worry about getting paint on the tables. You want to take that paint right to the edge so that you have a paper that has zero white spaces. Sometimes you have to really kind of drag it around. I'll just about finish the bottom. I'm going to finish painting the top of my picture. See how I'm just doing a combination of vertical. And you can do diagonal if you want. And you're going to finish painting the whole piece of paper. I am almost out of paint. Looks like I am going to need to get just a little bit more to finish this up. But at the end, you should have two fully painted pieces of colorful paper that you will put on the drying rack and wait for the next step. Thank you.